Hello everyone, what's up? For this quick edit video, I will be creating an HDR image using Adobe Photoshop with the Camera Raw Editor, and I'd like to apply a very warm and also very, very soft style on this image. So let's get started right away. Since I'm creating an HDR image, the beginning is a little different. So let's open the HDR sequence. For this, I'm using three differently exposed images. Then I'm just hitting the open button. Now you can see the series down there with those thumbnails. And the reason why I'm creating an HDR image here is because we have very, very strong highlights on this side of the image while we do have a super dark foreground. So by creating an HDR image, I am simply making sure to have details in all the areas of the image. To merge it, I'm simply selecting all three thumbnails down there, right click on them and go to Merge to HDR. In this case, I have selected align images. I don't want to apply auto settings since Photoshop will then automatically adjust the exposure, and that's not something I want. So let's just create it like that. So this is our HDR image. And the very first thing I want to do on it is to crop it a little bit. I want to have those mountains pretty much centered in this frame. So let's take away a part of the bottom of the image. I think something like that looks pretty good. Also, let's real quick activate this setting to remove chromatic aberrations. I'm not using the profile correction since the lens distortion isn't that bad in this case. Then for the camera profile, I'm simply going with Adobe Standard. You can see this will already help with the dark areas of the image a bit, but let's continue with the basic stuff. First off, for the white balance, as I want this image to be rather warm, I'm going with the cloudy setting, which will warmen up everything just a bit. Then let's drop the highlights first, and this way we get detail from the bright sky on the left side. Now let's also increase the shadows to get back detail from the darker parts. You can see that's not really helping that much, but don't worry, I will fix it later. For now, let's increase the whites. This just adds some more brightness. And then let's also increase the blacks. Okay. This picture right now is still super, super dark, and I want to fix that using local adjustments. So let's start with the gradiated filters. You can see there's much going on, but all of this isn't too complicated. Let's start by making this image brighter, and therefore I have applied this gradiated filter which lies outside of the image. That just means it covers the whole image, and to make it brighter, I could of course simply increase the exposure. The problem here is the highlights are also affected by this, and thus we end up with overexposure. So to target only the darker parts of the image, I can simply use a luminance range mask, and by adjusting the luminance range, I can filter out the highlights. So if I drop this pin, you can see the highlights will get less and less affected by this gradiated filter. So let's go with something like this, maybe add some smoothness. And the dark areas look much better now. We could also add some shadows to further increase this effect. Alright, of course due to this we lost a lot of contrast, so let's fix that right away. Okay, and we can bring back even more contrast by using local adjustments again. First off, I want to work on the sky and make it a little darker. Therefore, I have applied two differently sized gradiated filters. And let's just bring down the exposure slightly. Okay, then let's switch to the next one. And again, just drop the exposure. To make the sky look a little softer, I could also drop the texture, since we don't need any sharpness in this area anyway. And for the same effect, we could also drop the clarity. Alright, nice. Then let's work on the foreground. First off, I want to make the very near foreground just a little darker. So I'm using this bigger gradiated filter again to bring down the exposure. Alright, I'm making sure to not underexpose anything, but that looks good. And finally, for this one, I want to add some clarity in this area. Also, maybe some more contrast. Let's see, I could drop the highlights. And I could even drop the dehaze a little bit, just to give this area a soft effect. Okay, that looks pretty nice. That's it for the gradiated filters. Then for this shot I also have applied two radial filters. And as usual, I want to apply some nice glow effect on the brighter part of the image. So in this radial filter, let's just increase the blacks. Also, I'm dropping the dehaze to make this effect a little stronger. And to not lose too much colors in there, I'm also boosting the saturation. Alright, nice. Then you can see I have another radial filter which covers the whole center of this image. Again, I want to slightly increase the blacks and drop the dehaze just for a soft effect over this area. Nice, that's it for the local adjustments. Now let's continue doing some color grading, and I'm starting in the curves tab, in the rectangle. I'm simply picking up this point and drag it to the left just a little to give this image stronger sunset colors. Then in the color mixer tab, I want to go to the hue settings first. Right now I think the blue part of the sky has a little too strong purple color cast. To fix that, I can pick up the blue hues and just give it some more blue tones. Alright, then in the saturation tab, I want to drop the orange tones and the yellow tones. Okay, finally, I'm using the color grading to do some split toning, mainly for the highlights and the midtones, and for both of them, I want to apply a warm color tone. Again, this just helps to improve those sunset colors. Let's drop the saturation here. Okay, and then let's do the same for the midtones. Okay, that looks pretty good. Finally, we can sharpen this image. And now let's open it up in Photoshop. First off, of course I need to clean up this image from sensor spots and other distracting things, therefore I'm using the spot healing brush. Let's zoom in and just brush over all those spots. Alright, nice. Now I want to enhance this glow effect on the left side a little more, therefore I'm using a new layer and switch the blending mode to soft light. I'm picking up the brush by pressing B, and while holding down the Alt key, I click in this area to pick up this color tone. Also, I'm dropping the brush opacity, just to make sure this effect isn't too strong. And then I just start to paint in there a few times. And give everything a softer look in here. Alright, that looks cool. Next up, I'm creating another layer, and this time go with the overlay blending mode. Let's increase the brush opacity, and I'm changing the color to pure white. Now I want to make those rocks in the foreground a little brighter, so I'm just carefully brushing over them. I could give them some color by changing the foreground color to a warmer tone. Okay. Now let's merge everything, and finally I want to take a look at the Knit Collection plugin. First, I'm going with the polarization effect, which will just help to make those colors look a little nicer. So let's turn up the strength. I think that looks good. And also I'm adding another filter right away. This time I'm going with the Glamour Glow effect. Let's bring back the saturation some more. Also, let's make the glow a little stronger. And let's introduce some more warmth. Alright, that looks nice. Let's apply it like this. Looking at the sky, I think it's a little bit noisy in there. So what I want to do here, I'm going to duplicate this layer. Now I'm going to filter, blur, add motion blur. Now I'm making sure to set the angle to 0, which means the motion blur goes from left to right. And let's increase the distance a little bit and then apply it like this. Then I'm applying a black layer mask to this layer by holding down the Alt key and clicking this icon right there. Then I'm picking up the brush tool, set the foreground color to white, and now I'm just brushing over the sky part. And it's a very subtle change, but it does have a big impact. And at this point, I want to stop the editing. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have questions left, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.